determine the roots of the function f of x equals x times x minus 1 quantity squared times x plus 3 quantity raised to the fifth power, and state whether the graph crosses the x-axis at each root or just touches the x-axis. First of all, let's talk about finding the roots of the function. The roots. There is a root at a function, a root at every value x equals c, when a factor is in the form x minus c. So for example, we have a factor x minus 1. It's in that form of x minus c. So 1, x equals 1, is a root of the function. And a root of the function is where the function equals 0. And when the function equals 0, the graph of the function will cross the x-axis or just touch the x-axis. Okay, so let's run through these one by one and find the roots. The first factor is x. X, written in this form of x minus c, can be written as x minus 0. We're not changing the value or anything. We're just saying x minus 0 is the same as x, which is true. So that means that a root, one of the roots, is x equals 0. So I'm just going to put that right there on the x-axis, x equals 0. Okay, the next one. Let's talk about the next factor, x minus 1. We looked at this already. X minus 1 is all raised to the second power. So we know that the root, because it's already in that form of x minus c, the root is at x equals 1. And I'll put a dot there as well, at x equals 1, right along the x-axis. Next, let's look at x plus 3. All right, this factor of x plus 3, all raised to the fifth power. And we can rewrite this as x minus a negative 3. And we're just playing that trick to make it look like this form of x minus c. So now we have x minus a negative 3, which is the same thing as x plus 3, all raised to the fifth power. So we can say that there is a root at x equals negative 3. So I'll put a dot there as well, along the x-axis where x equals negative 3. Now let's look at whether or not it crosses the x-axis or just touches the x-axis. Well, if you have an exponent of 1, or 3, or 5, or 7, an odd exponent on the factor, then we call that odd multiplicity. So if, let me spell this real quickly, odd multiplicity. If you have an odd multiplicity, we're going to say that the graph crosses the x-axis. So I'm just going to write a note to ourselves, cross. And that's when x is 0. So it's going to go a little bit like this. And I kind of know beforehand that it's going to go from lower to upper, because I know the other option is from upper to lower. We know that it does cross. Next, let's look at the case where the root is x equals 1 right here. Here, our exponent on the factor is even, so we have even multiplicity. And when you have even multiplicity, that is when the exponent on the factor is 2 or 4 or 6, then we can say that it just, the graph of the function just touches the x-axis at that point, at that root. So it's going to curve like this. Just touch, not go across. All right, and I could just right now just go ahead and finish that off, that little section. I don't know if it looks exactly like this. We'd have to plug in some numbers to see, but I do know that it just touches at x equals 1 and it crosses at x equals 0. Next, when x equals negative 3, we have an odd exponent on the factor. So again, we have odd multiplicity. And I'll write that down, and then you guessed it. That means odd multiplicity means that the graph will cross the x-axis at that point of x equals negative 3. So it's going to go down like this. Now, I don't really know, without further investigation, I don't really know what the rest of the graph looks like, if this goes down a lot farther or if there's some wiggles, but I do know that it crosses at x equals negative 3, it crosses at x equals 0, and it just touches the x-axis when x equals 1.